Welcome back to the Enlightened Logger channel. Today, two-thirds of the junkyard crew trucked out to Marietta in the upstate here. I'm gonna pan you around so you get to see what we're working on. Brought the tractor out. We're gonna be doing some brush hogging and some other work for the owner. We got Jake over there on the John Deere. Just got that thing offloaded. We also got some blocks in Pawpaw here that we brought out that he wants to use. Look at that view, guys. Just awesome. So we're gonna get set up here. We're gonna get trailer parked, truck parked, and set up for the next couple of hours worth of work we've got going on. But we got some pretty good stuff coming for you today. I'm gonna walk with Pawpaw, Jake here, back up the drive just a little bit. We've got kind of a tight squeeze in here for a truck this big. We gotta set the blocks off to the side up here just a little bit. And we're gonna do a little bit of brush hogging. Get this kind of prepped. Just an absolutely beautiful day here. Supposed to be low 70s and sunny again. Again, you can see the awesome fall colors. Love the stages. You got all these leaves falling and change colors and on the ground. And then you still got a lot of trees that still have color and some are still green because they haven't really started to turn much yet. So just awesome living here in upstate South Carolina. Backing up, we had to stop because you can see how low this wire is here. The right side of the truck, as the wire dips here, the right side of the truck was just starting to hit on that bottom wire, and I didn't feel comfortable because I didn't want it to snag on something. So left side was okay, because you could see there's quite a bit of distance there between the ground where I'm pointing and that wire. But this is where a second guy comes in real handy for times like this to spot that, because there was no way for him to see that back right corner of that box where it was starting to rub. So he's gonna get these blocks offloaded. I'm gonna film that for him quick. This is in the general vicinity of where he wanted them anyway, so that'll work out fine. About handy, these debris trucks. Boy, you can really move a lot of different material with it. I know a lot of the guys in Florida right now are using them for the cleanup of the hurricane. These blocks are quite a bit smaller than what I had for my bunks up north. Nice shape. Pretty easy. Most equipment can move them, you know, most smaller equipment. Plus they've got the hooks on them with that rebar, so if you had to put a chain on them, you could. Good grip on there. This concrete is not the same as wood when it comes to using a grapple on. Wood's got that bark and the ability to bite into it a little bit. Concrete, however, not quite so much give. If you don't have one of those ribs, like that block came off sideways, you really want to make sure that you're okay, because you look at that guy there, he does not have a lot of grip on that. thing to take into consideration is the fact that concrete tends to be fairly brittle. So when you're setting them down, you want to be careful so you don't chip them all up and make a mess. Needless to say, we're going to be a lot lighter going home. These blocks are probably just a little less than a ton a piece. But still, adds up. Here is off of a chestnut oak. It's such a cool looking leaf, serrated, in the shape that it's in. We're up at the top of the hill here, gonna load up these firewood logs here. Said he didn't want them, and yeah, there's a couple of pine in there, but we'll set those off to the side. But we need some more firewood logs back at the shop, so we're gonna get these loaded up quick, and we're gonna get back to the rush hogging down there, and we'll head back to the job. What a beautiful sunny day, guys. Pretty cool.